Welcome to the new session of complex variables. In this session, we shall be discussing how to write the CR equations in polar form and what will be the differential equation or what will be the derivative of a function in polar form. So the CR equation in polar form is del u by del r is 1 by r del v by del theta, and del u by del theta is minus r del v by del r. So let's see how we come to the CR equations in polar forms. So we know that the Cartesian coordinate can be expressed in the polar form as x is equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sine theta. And a complex variable z is represented as x plus iota y. So substituting the values of x and y, we write it as r cos theta plus iota r sine theta, and r is taken out constant common. So we get r times cos theta plus iota sine theta, and for cos theta plus iota sine theta, it is written as e to the power iota theta. So cos theta plus iota sine theta is the exponential form, so it is e to the power iota theta. Now we know that the complex variable function f of z is equal to w, which is also written as u plus iota v, where u is the real part and v is the imaginary part. And since the z is here, we have already derived that z is equal to r e to power iota theta, so del v by del r. So we are partially differentiating this equation with respect to r. So on the right hand side, we have the function f of r e to power iota theta. So partially differentiating with respect to r, what we get that first the function will be first differentiated, and then the bracket term, that is the r e to power iota theta, will be differentiated with respect to r. So we get f dash r e to power iota theta, and then we have to differentiate the r e to power iota theta with respect to r. So since in this term only r is here and exponential is not having any r term, so differentiating this equation with respect to r, we get it as e to power iota theta. Similarly, when we differentiate this equation with respect to theta, we get the equation as del u by del theta plus iota del v by del theta is del by del theta of f r e to power iota theta. Again, first this f will be differentiated, and then the bracket term, that is r e to power iota theta, will be differentiated, so that we get the equation as f dash r e to power iota theta del by del theta of r e to power iota theta. So we get as f dash r e to power iota theta. Now the theta is involved only with the exponential term, so only this factor has to be differentiated, so that we get it as iota r e to power iota theta. Now we know that this f dash r e to power iota theta e to power iota theta is del u by del r plus iota del v by del r. So in the b equation, we substitute the value of this term as del u by del r plus iota del v by del r. So equating a and b and substituting the values, we get the equation as del u by del theta plus iota del v by del theta is iota r times del u by del r plus iota del v by del r. So we get an equation which consists the terms of the partial differentials of u and v with respect to r and theta. And now we can equate the real and imaginary parts on both the sides. So on equating the real part, what we get that del u by del theta is equal to minus of r del v by del r. And equating the imaginary part, we get it as del u by del r is 1 by r del v by del theta. So these are the two equations that were needed, which were called as the CR equations in the polar form. So we can simply calculate the polar equations, that is for the CR equations. So this is the CR equations in the polar form, which can be readily used for solving the complex variable equations. So let's calculate the derivative of fz or the w in the polar form. So just now we have calculated the CR equations in the polar form. So we shall use those CR equation in the polar form equations to write the derivative of f of z in the polar form. So the polar form of the equation of the derivative would be dw by dz will be cos theta minus iota sine theta del w by del r, and which will also be written as minus iota by r cos theta minus iota sine theta del w by del theta. So these are the two ways in which we can express the derivative of f of z in the polar form. So let's start the proof of the derivative of f of z in polar form. We know that our function f of z, which is w, is written as u plus iota v, where u is the real part and v is the imaginary part. Now, if we partially differentiate our w with respect to x, because u and v both are the functions of x and y. So just partially differentiating with x, we can write the equation as del w by del x is del u by del x plus iota del v by del x. Now we know that x is r cos theta and y is the r sine theta. So if we square and add both the two equations of x and y, we shall be getting as x square is equal to r square cos square theta and y square is equal to r square sine square theta. So adding the two, we shall get x square plus y square is equal to r square. In return, we shall get r is equal to under root of x square plus y square. And if we divide x and y, that is y by x, we get theta is equal to tan inverse y by x, because tan theta will be y by x. So theta will be tan inverse of y by x. So this is the argument part and this is the modulus part, that is the r value. So now dw by dz can be written as, because z is a function of r and theta, so we can write it as del w by del r into del r by del x plus del w by del theta into del theta by del x. Because just now we had seen that our z variable was expressed as r e ki power iota theta. So z is a function of r and eta. So we are writing our complete differential dw by dz as a result of the partial derivatives as del w by del r into del r by del x plus del w by del theta into del theta by del x. So we have here that we substitute the values of del r by del x and del theta by del x. Now we can see here that x is equal to r cos of theta. So if we differentiate, or and we know that y is equal to r sine theta, and our r was equal to under root of x square plus y square. So now we have to calculate del r by del x. So we shall be using this r is equal to under root of x square plus y square equation to calculate del r by del x. So if we differentiate our partially differentiate r with respect to x, what we'll get? We'll get it as 1 upon root 2 root of x square plus y square, and the differential of x square plus y square will be again 2x. So this is the derivative of del r by del x. And similarly, now what we want the value of del theta by del x. And it is given here that theta is tan inverse of y by x. You can see here that theta is tan inverse by y by x. So we want del theta by del x. So I shall differentiate my theta with respect to x. So if I differentiate my theta with respect to x, what I get? I will get this as 1 upon 1 plus y square by x square into differential of this bracketed term, that is y by x, and since it is the differentiation as minus of y by x square. So I get the value of del r by del x, and I get the value of del theta by del x, which is found out to be this bracketed terms. So now solving this equation, I can write for x is equal to r cos theta, and for under root of x square plus y square, I can write it as r. So I substitute the values of x as r cos theta and under root of x square plus y square as r. And for this w, I write it as u plus iota v. So it is del by del theta of u plus iota v. And here you can again see it, that if I solve it, if I rationalize it, what I get? I get it here as x square plus y square upon x square. So this x square gets cancelled with this x square. And so I am left out with the term of minus y upon x square plus y square. So there is a negative sign here. So for y, I write it as r sine theta. And here it is x square plus y square. So it is a r square term. So this r gets cancelled with the square term. And we are left out with this term. So I get it now del w by del r cos theta minus del u by del theta plus iota del v by del theta into sine theta by r. Now I make use of the CR equations here. So what I do here, now I make a substitution for del u by del theta. I am writing it as minus r of del v by del r. And for del v by del theta, I am writing it as r into del u by del r. Basically, I am trying to convert all the derivative with respect to theta in terms of derivative with respect to r. So I have converted del u by del theta and del v by del theta using the polar equations. So I am writing it as now as del w by del r cos theta minus iota del u by del r plus iota del v by del r into sine theta. So I get this equation as del w by del r cos theta minus iota del by del r is taken common now. It is u plus iota v sine theta. So for u plus iota v, again we substitute as del w by del r because u plus iota v is w. So I get del w by del r cos theta minus iota del w by del r sine theta. And I can find it that this del w by del r is common in both the terms. So I get the equation as del w by del r into cos theta minus iota sine theta. So similarly, how we can now express the derivative of fz in polar form in another equation. So let us see how we can approach to that equation. So again, dw by dz is written again same as dw del w by del r into del r by del x plus del w by del theta into del theta by del x. First of all, we had replaced the w with u plus iota v with respect to the theta term. Now I am replacing w by u plus iota v with the radial term, that is with respect to r. So here it is del of u plus iota v upon del r. And for del r by del x, we have calculated the value of r cos theta. So r and r got cancelled and I got it as cos theta. So for del r by del x, we substitute the value of cos theta. And similarly for del theta by del x, we have it as sine theta by r. So del theta by del x is substituted as sine theta by r. So I can see here, I get the equation as del u by del r plus iota del v by del r cos theta minus del w by del theta into sine theta by r. Now I replace my partial derivative with respect to r into partial derivative with respect to theta using the CR equations in the polar form. So for del u by del r, I write it as 1 by r del v by del theta. And for del v by del r, I write it as minus of 1 by r del u by del theta. So this is the CR equation in the polar form. So by replacing the equations in using the CR equation, we get 1 by r del v by del theta minus iota by r del u by del theta cos theta minus del w by del theta sine theta by r. So now clubbing the terms, we get minus iota by r del u by del theta plus iota del v by del theta cos theta minus of del w by del theta sine theta by r. So this del by del theta gets common. We get it as u plus iota v. So it is minus iota by r del by del theta u plus iota v cos theta minus del w by del theta sine theta by r. So we get the equation as dw by dz is minus iota by r del w by del theta cos theta minus del w by del theta sine theta by r. So del w by del theta is taken out common. So I get it equation as minus iota by r cos theta minus iota sine theta del w by del theta. So this is the one equation of dw by dz in terms of theta. And this is another equation of dw by dz in terms of del w by del r. And what we find is that this cos theta minus iota sine theta is common in both the terms. You can see here that cos theta minus iota sine theta is common in both the terms. So we can find a, establish a relationship between the partial derivative of w with respect to r and theta. So on comparing the two equations, what we find out? We find out that the relation between them is that the del w by del r is minus iota by r del w by del theta. So that is the partial derivative of w with respect to r is equal to minus iota by r times the partial derivative of w with respect to theta. So this is the derivative of fz in the polar coordinates. And this equation is the relationship between the partial derivative of w with respect to r and theta. So using these equations, we can very easily solve the numericals of the complex variables. So thank you, and meet you again. Thank you.